वीक फोर पार्ट टू। क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स। इन वन डायमेंशन ए रैंडम वॉकर टेक्स ए स्टेप विद इक्वल प्रोबेबिलिटी टू लेफ्ट और राइट। व्हाट इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट द वॉकर रिटर्न्स टू द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट आफ्टर फोर स्टेप्स? सो देर इज ए डायरेक्ट फॉर्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग द आंसर, बट आई वुड रादर लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन दिस प्रॉब्लम using the following diagram. So here you can see the four steps being taken by the random walker. So let us say that he starts from the mean position. So he could take either to left or right. So the probability is that half for each. So by computing these probabilities, I find that to come back to the mean position, we have a total probability of 3 by 16 plus 3 by 16, that is 3 by 8. Hence the answer. Question number 7. The van der Waals equation of state for a gas is given by P plus A by V square into V minus B equal to RT, where P, V, T has the usual meaning and A and B are constants. At a critical point, we are asked to find the volume. So in critical point, we have to remember that dou p by dou v equal to 0 and dou square p by dou v square equal to 0. Using dou p by dou v equal to 0, we arrive that RT by V minus B all square is equal to 2A by V cube. And dou square p by dou v square equal to 0, we arrive at 2RT by V minus B all cube equal to 6A by V raised to 4. Solving 1 and 2, we get V minus B by 2 equal to V by 3. So we will get V equal to 3B. Question number 8. The recently discovered Higgs boson at LHC experiment has a decay mode into a photon and an Z boson. If the rest mass of the Higgs boson and Z boson are 125 GeV and 90 GeV respectively, the decaying Higgs boson particle is at rest. The energy of the photon will be approximately. So we have an equation, this Higgs boson H changing to gamma plus Z0. Now there is a simple interpretation to the answer that if you go for non-relativistic calculation, E of photon becomes 35 GeV. But we know according to relativity, the energy will be less than 35 GeV and closer to 35 GeV. So the answer will be 30 GeV. But let us find using the relativistic expression for energy. Now the energy of the Z boson is E is equal to root of P square C square plus M square C raised to 4. Now P of Z boson is equal to P of photon. So energy of photon E equal to PC. So therefore, energy of Z boson becomes root of energy of gamma square plus m square c raised to 4. So we'll get root of E square plus 90 square. Hence, 125 equal to root of E square plus 90 square plus E. Solving by squaring the equation, we get energy is equal to 30.1 GeV. So relativistic expression for energy is a very important question in CSIR. Question number 9. A permanently deformed even-even nucleus with J equal to 2P, 2 plus, has rotational energy 93 keV. The energy of the next excited state is, we know, energy for rotation is equal to h cut square by 2i j into j plus 1. For j equal to 2, E is equal to 93. So we get h cut square by i equal to 31. And the next excited state for even even nuclei is 4 plus. That is the condition. For even even nuclei, the next excited state will be 4 plus. So substituting, we will get 310 keV. So answer is 2. Question number 10. The pressure of a non-relativistic free Fermi gas in 3 dimension depends at T equal to 0 on density of fermions n. So we should learn the relation for Fermi energy. We should also learn the relation of pressure with respect to Fermi energy. We know Fermi energy is proportional to n raised to 2 by 3. Hence the pressure will be equal to 2 by 5 n EF. So pressure will be proportional to n raised to 5 by 3. So I advise the students to properly go through the expressions for Fermi energy, pressure, etc., which is discussed in statistical mechanics. So let us conclude by a quote by Feynman. I think I can safely say that no one understands quantum mechanics. And in which sense this becomes a motivational is that anyone can learn quantum mechanics. Thank you.